Hi, my friends. How are you? I hope everybody's fine. My name is Daniel Villarino. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In the previous video, I gave some theoretical information regarding the correction factor for using the shadow method for turning. And in the previous one, I actually turned a trompo using the shadow method. And for doing that, I used this platform made out of a box in which I attach on the surface the silhouette that I was going to use to make the trompo. And to the box I made this hole so that the banjo of the tool rest could go through that hole. Now the problem was that still in this case I was hitting the box all the time with the tool rest, and these wings that it had that I used to use adhesive tape to attach it to the lathe bed didn't work too well because of the dust and the shavings. The adhesive tape didn't adhere really well, so it didn't work that well. So I want to do something that is a little more stable. In the previous videos I gave a couple of articles from David Reed Smith and also from Doc Green, and in those articles they explain how to make these platforms out of wood more stable and sturdy. So I want to do something similar so I can keep using this method in the future. Particularly I want to turn spheres. So today we are going to build this platform with wood. That's today's project. I hope you enjoy it. Let's get to work. The first thing I do is to trace on the lathe bed the projection of the most external part of the chuck and the spur center. I want the base of the platform to be between the headstock base and the colossus line. That way I ensure that the base will not bother the banjo. The width of this piece of wood is perfect for the base. After each cut, I sand a bit the corners to eliminate any possible splinters. From below the bed, I mark the space so that I know what areas are going to be touching the bed. In more or less approximated fashion, I trace the centers for the 8 recesses I will make to later glue the magnets. The magnets have a diameter of about 3/4 inch and a thickness of about 1/8 inch. With a bit, I make the 8 recesses.
I use CA glue to attach the magnets. I'm going to cut two square face pieces to use as reinforcements. I measure the distance between the bed and the rotation axis. It's approximately 9 inches. I'm going to make the platform 6 inches tall. With this, I can turn objects up to 6 inches in diameter. I have cut two more pieces. The smaller will be the post and the longer the crossbar. Now it's just a matter of assembling the pieces, and for that I will use screws. I got this thin piece of particle board from the bottom of an old drawer. It will be a nice support for the piece of paper where I will draw the silhouettes. When I attach the post to the crossbar, I want it to be in such a way that the top of the board will be 6 inches from the bed. Now I have to connect the post to the base, but first I need to screw the reinforcement. Before screwing the base, I check that the crossbar is level. If it is not, I can shim it up with a bit of Turner's tape where it is needed to level it off. Attaching the base to the post and the post to the crossbar, we finish assembling the platform. As you can see, the banjo can slide under the platform without touching anything.
Okay, my friends, I just finished making the platform where we are going to attach the silhouettes for the shadow turning method. You can see it here. It's very simple. It has a base where I put these magnets inserted over there. You can also make a hole in the middle if you want, pass a bolt, and then with a nut from below the lathe, you can actually grasp it more securely even. But the magnets have worked pretty well even with the weight of the arm here. It's a very simple construction. I use just scraps of wood that I had. And on the top, you have this plaque that is made of thin material. This is particulate board, actually, from I think it was a drawer that I had. And there you can attach the silhouette to be turned. And it's very easy to put it there with this clamp like this, like that. Or you can rotate it and put it like that if it is more convenient, depending on the work that you want to do. So in the next video, I will try to do a sphere using this method and using this platform. The idea is that because of the space that there is here, the banjo of the tool rest can go easily underneath and move around without having to worry about touching the platform. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. If that's the case, please don't forget to click on the like button below, make comments, and if you haven't subscribed yet to my channel, please do so. And it will be until the next one. Cheers.